Oilers 1-for-1 on the power play. Big scramble for the puck. McGinn goes down in a heap, and that's going to be a late call.
Oh, I know. It was a late guy, too. I thought he went for a little bit of a flop. Now Jari goes down, takes out Draisaitl. What's going on here?
Had the collision at center.
I think they're going to call two penalties here against Edmonton. The referee just pointed at Draisaitl. He said, who, me? I think two penalties might be called against Edmonton here. Let's take a look, see what we got. Is it just the
just
one?
Just the trip.
Okay.
By Dan O'Rourke, working his game with Corey Stavrette.
That was the one they called there when McGinn went down on Hyman. But right here, you could see Jari. They both felt the contact and went down, each trying to really draw a penalty there.
And that will do it. So the Islanders come out and score four goals in the second period. The Blues have a goal called back as Binnington and the Blues trail 4-1 after two. And Binnington having words with a couple of Islanders like he did with some Kings players the other night. Coming up next, the Jack in the Box second intermission report. And the Blues can't maintain control of the Kings the other way. And Grundstrom from the angle shoots and he scores over the shoulder of a surprised Binnington. And it's 5-0.
That's going to bring Thomas Greisch into the game. And you know, the tough part of this is that, you know, Jordan Binnington is out there and he's battling, and there's a lot of the passes that are off to the post that are just really difficult plays to make as a goaltender. You have to trust the fact that players are covered back door, and that's part of the evolution of winning together. That's what happened in 2019 when they started trusting one another. Well, this play here has Binnington a little reluctant to get out of there. Shot from a sharp angle. It glanced off of Falk's stick. It wasn't a clean shot on him. I mean, and that's, and Jordan Binnington having some words with the LA Kings bench as he goes by, but
that one got away. It's a race for the puck. Coming out of his net is Dell. Dell's got Tolman and they collide along the boards. It's still up for grabs and sent back to center. Dangerous play. Now the chase is on the other side and a penalty call is coming up.
Yep. Dell's going to the box there. He made contact. You can see Tolman goes over and has a few words for him. Oh, right here. Look, Tolman trying to avoid contact, and Dell steps into it and lays a hit there. So obvious interference call there. He's in no man's land there. So big opportunity here for the Preds. Only 24.2 left in the period.
It's not good news for Drake Batherson. An ankle injury, which they're calling long-term. He's going to miss next week's All-Star game after that collision with Sabres goalie Arendelle. Sneaky little shoulder right there. The Sens didn't like it one bit. Here's their post-game reaction as Batherson left the ice in pain.
No harm done for the Wild. It's Gallagher's turn to wind it up. Brandon Gallagher. He got slapped from behind. Puck taken away, courtesy Juhayev. Joel Eriksson Ek on the move for the Wild. Come back in Wild territory. Brandon Gallagher cutting in, taken down as the Habs trail by one.
I think what Brandon Gallagher's upset about is not the Duhaime play. Right here, watch Marc-Andre Fleury pull Gallagher's helmet off. Now, under the new rules, you can't pull a guy's helmet off. That's a penalty. And I think that's what he's upset about.
And he's found a home, certainly here in Colorado. This shot by Girard just wide as Rodriguez tried to get a stick on it. Now to Chushkin with a shot. That gets through. Markstrom squeezes the pads, and then Weegar throws a hit on Rodriguez, and that draws a reaction.
All right, this is the first scrum of the game. Yeah. All right, breaks up pretty quickly, but nice to see Weegar standing up for his teammates, going after Rodriguez. Greatly appreciated by Markstrom. You can see the pat by Markstrom. And that's why Rodriguez is right in the crease. You can see Markstrom giving Rodriguez a couple of whacks as well. And the big Nichushkin comes in there. That's a big man, but yep, that's sending a message. Can't be in the crease.
You got a hey, stick's player. Getting high, and Gibson's involved. with Ernie, and everybody will come together. I didn't see how it started, but Gibson was angry about something, Bush.
Well, he went out and played the puck earlier. Wonder if there was any contact when that happened. Of the season, as we look at the penalties that were called, this one elbow there, not much. A slash and then a shove here. I think that, no question, is a penalty. The shove. I think the other ones were more light taps that I'm sure Gibson didn't quite agree with as well.
Timeout, a little altercation. It looked like Nick Foligno was yapping at Jamie Drysdale over in front of the Anaheim bench. And John Gibson didn't like that. So he came over, gave him a little shot. A little melee ensued. I don't think any penalties were called at the end of this. Ryan Getzlaf got in there immediately to have a few words. But there's Gibson. Oh, that's old time throwing the blocker. Tear in my eye there, John. Foligno was yapping at Drysdale, and obviously he's trying to intimidate the young defenseman for the Ducks.
To Nader for Drysdale with Kane to the net, and that passed too hard, and then Binnington gave Kane a bit of a shot in the head. And now the Blues to center, they dump it in. That's the second odd man break tonight for Edmonton.
They've got to get things going. And here's the Evander Kane. Near miss, and then Jordan Binnington, there you go. Take that with you. Complimentary, no charge for that one.
John, I was looking at the monitor down here between the benches, and whoa, wow, that was at Kadri right there. And that was, if he wants to swing, he can, but he gave him a swing and a miss right there.
And then he shot the puck toward Kemper.
Yeah, that's the part that I missed that part.
Right. So he's trying to fire up his team.
All this with a young and inexperienced officiating crew. And here we go with 91 comes over there afterwards. And Binnington's not going to back away from that.
Steals Gaudreau, a pass in front, puck blocked down by Smith. And now Smith isn't going to like that as Tkachuk is near the net. Tempers flaring. As the former teammates with the war of words, Darnell Nurse takes the gloves off. Matthew Tkachuk having none of that. But of course, it's Matthew Tkachuk out there causing a disturbance, and he always gets a reaction, doesn't he, Cassie?
He does, and I think Darnell Nurse, prior to this, saves a goal, as it was a beautiful play from Gaudreau to Tkachuk, and Darnell Nurse just gets back in time to get a piece of Kachuk's stick.
So we'll take a look at what the officials decide. As they're motioning towards the players, Matthew Tkachuk making his way to the penalty box.
And there's the play by Darnell Nurse. And Smith doesn't like the stick. Nurse gives Tkachuk a shot. And it's 8-5 Flames on hockey night.
And another penalty coming here. Fiala is thrown to the ice. Larson grabbed him and threw him down as Fiala was otherwise in on a breakaway against Grubauer.
Again, Fiala with some jump. Take away in the neutral zone. Adam Larson gets underneath, steals the puck, forces Larson to haul him down. Grubauer takes exception too.
Seattle number 6, minor penalty holding.
And that illustrates
the guys that you're starting with aren't going to do the job.
He did have 2 overtime winners last time I checked in the regular season.
Right. Hathaway looks to move out in front. Rask.
Oh, Rask is doing a blocker. He got about 4 or 5 shots.
And continues to take some shots.
On Hathaway.
Yeah, Rask.
desk isn't happy. He talks to the official Dan O'Rourke. He got his head knocked pretty good. And oftentimes for goalies, when you're on your knees, a lot of post play, you know, the head can be exposed. And Hathaway is one of those guys who just does it the hard way. And watch, this puck gets around the net. Rask will be on his knees. And eventually, the play that I'm talking about, Hathaway will take it to the net right here. Watch how Rask's head is exposed right there. But it's a shove by Coyle that catapults Hathaway into Rask at the last second. See the push there by Coyle?
Right.
But Rask doesn't know that, right? He's so focused on the puck.
Watch him now here, Bush, with the blocker. You did that a couple of times in your career.
Oh, yeah. A couple of free shots there.
Now Kane gets it back again. One man back through. Kane takes the shot and scores! That's two for Evander Kane tonight.
Like, is it the look? Like, not sure how that went in, but it went in because he hustled in the defensive zone. Right here. Right there, he wins the puck. Accelerates, uses Krug as a screen, and somehow, some way, beats Binnington. Let's take a look from this angle. And a little deflection again off Krug. I think that was all it needed to kind of throw it off from Binnington to lose sight of it for that split second. It goes over the short side on the glove.
Shoot for the glove side, right?
It seems like both these goaltenders are getting beat tonight out with a glove, but that just good hustle defensively. It leads to the chance, and you get some breaks once in a while. Now Binnington going over to the bench here.
And are we going to have a goaltending change? I believe we are, as the backup goaltender, Ville Husso, is getting set. He's not seated on the bench. There's not enough room on the visitor's bench here at SAP Center for the backup goaltender. So Ville Husso in the tunnel coming back out. Now Binnington getting after it with Dubnyk. As Dubnyk and Binnington come together on Binnington's way off the ice.
Well, Eric Karlsson in the neutral zone, I'm not sure what happened, but Binnington went after Karlsson. And then, obviously, then Devin Dubnyk came out to say something to Binnington. I thought they were going to drop the gloves.
Minor penalty on sportsmanlike conduct.
Unsportsmanlike conduct, I believe, was just given to Binnington. And that will put the Sharks on a power play here.
And here's where Binnington takes his swat right there at Karlsson. And I'm not sure, he's just upset getting pulled. Now he's talking to Dubnyk as he's going off. And I'm not sure I'd want to tussle with Devin Dubnyk with the size of him. And that's probably why Binnington heads for the shower.